Oh. touch you is a dream come true. So I'm standing here with my hand held out, knowing that your love will never fade. I stand amazed without a doubt. I want to hear your voice in the morning when I rise. Think I know I'm just a normal man, only made of sand, except when you're by my side. Will you love me, teach me, don't leave me, I pray. When I'm thinking of the times, your hands and mine, together we'll stay. You made me better today than I was before. Now my heart can rest, and I will search no more.
Woman away.
My heart is weak.
Hey. Friends and family of the bride and groom, welcome and thank you for being here for this memorable occasion. We are gathered together to celebrate the special love between Cameron and Michaela, joining them in marriage. To express what marriage means to them, Cam and Michaela have chosen the letter that Paul Newman wrote his wife on their wedding day. I will read it now. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife angel wings. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which they can grow and finding room for things of the spirit. It is a common search for good and the beautiful. It's establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. We will now present the rings. May these rings symbolize your inherent wholeness and unity with one another, giving you the strength to happily honor your commitments to each other. May they remind you that marriage is not a destination, but a journey, with no beginning and no end, just a moment-to-moment opportunity to love and be loved to the best of your ability. Cameron, do you promise to show up every day and try to be the best version of yourself for Michaela?
I do.
Do you promise to honor, cherish, and care for her whenever she needs your love and support?
I do.
Do you commit to encouraging her as an individual through all of life's changes?
I do.
Do you promise to be open and speak the truth from a place of love?
I do.
Do you accept her with all her faults and strengths?
I do.
Cameron, do you take Michaela to be your lawfully wedded wife.
I do.
To love her faithfully today, tomorrow, and as long as you both shall live.
I do. Get it.
Michaela, do you promise to show up every day and try to be the best version of yourself for Cameron?
I do.
Do you promise to honor, cherish, and care for him whenever he needs your love and support?
I do.
Do you commit to encouraging him as an individual through all of life's changes?
I do.
Do you accept him with all his faults and strengths?
I do.
Do you promise to be open and speak the truth from a place of love? And Michaela, do you take Cameron to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love him faithfully today, tomorrow, and as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Let us celebrate Cameron and Michaela as they begin this journey and take their next steps into life together. And now, by the power vested in me by the state of California, it is my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. May you go forth and live each day to the fullest. And Cameron, you may now kiss your bride. I'm pleased to present the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Michaela and Cameron Abercrombie. Photographs. Everyone else, if you just follow down the path to the barn, we'll start the reception.
So sweet, the scent is all around my head.
Everything about you. I love your heart, and I love how much you are so positive all the time, and I love how hard you're working and how supportive you've always been. And I love everything about you, and you've got beautiful eyes.
Oh, yeah, they're blue for you.
I love your laugh.
I love everything about you. The way you treat me, the way you help me grow up in life and are supportive of everything that I do, the way that you look at me in the morning. I cannot leave the house without kissing you. It's not a thing, and it's not going to happen. You're perfect in every simple way. Mm. Love everything about you. The way you treat me and the dogs and all of this. I don't deserve you, but I got you. I love it. We're together. You said yes. Yeah, you said yes. You're stuck.
No applause, just throw money because this shit costs a lot of money and I got four daughters. Now, all kidding aside, but Caitlin being the youngest, I'm already tearing up. it's been a blessing.
You got a heart.
So, when you have four daughters, it's a lot of trials. Any guys with daughters out there, I feel sorry for you. But they're worth it. Sons, you can kick to the curb. It's fine, because they ignore you after they grow up. Daughters, they keep coming back. Don't know why. Sometimes we don't deserve it. But that being said, they steal part of your heart. So she's the last one. welcome. Thank you for celebrating with us, and it's our pleasure. Please have fun, eat a lot of food. It cost me a shit ton of money. The booze is paid for, so enjoy that too. And I don't think there's anything else. Have fun. The choreographed dancing starts a little later on. If you didn't make the practices, fake it. And my lovely wife, Monica, who has put up with me for way longer than I deserve, will bless her food.
Lord Jesus, thank you so much for this wonderful day. You gave us beautiful weather. It was perfect, not too hot, not too cold, with a slight breeze. An occasional wind gust, but, you know, that's okay. We need to blow the seeds around to grow more plants. But thank you for this food. The hands that prepared this food, please bless them. Bless the hands that serve this food for us. And those of us that are here to celebrate with Michaela and Cameron, I ask that you help us all just enjoy one another's company. Help us to have fun. And I ask, Lord, that you enter into this marriage with Michaela and Cameron. Help them, Lord, to look to you for guidance, for strength, for wisdom, for peace, and for joy. We love you. We thank you for the ability to come together and enjoy this day. In your precious Son, Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you. All right, so hello, everyone. How are you guys doing? For those who don't know me, my name is Charlene, and I am one of the two matrons of honors this evening. I have known Michaela since 2008, and she has been my best and longest friend since. We met our sophomore year at Folsom High in our zero period PE class, and we quickly realized that we both shared a bond over 90s boy bands and Monica's buttermilk pancakes. Pancake Fridays were a thing for us. Michaela, the Thursday night, would make the pancake batter. Friday morning, she would cook the pancakes, and by 7 a.m., we'd be running laps and stretching and eating pancakes. Our teachers were not very happy about that. A few years later, we both found ourselves causing trouble together at Bath & Body Works, where we both worked. We were nicknamed Sharkayla because we desperately tried to do everything together. But unfortunately for us, our managers were pretty successful in splitting us up. I worked on the sales floor at the register, and Michaela was in the stockroom. But Michaela was okay with this because she would always say, "I don't want to talk to people." The funny thing about Michaela is that as extroverted and playful and chatty as we know her to be, around people she doesn't know, she's a little more shy and introverted. Over the years I've known her, I can tell when she's genuinely having a good time and is happy, or she's talking to you because she has to. You don't get the full Michaela experience until she has decided that she likes you and that you are her person. Which brings me to this guy right here, Cameron. I remember the first time we met him, me and my husband, we double dated with Michaela and the cute car guy. This is very early in their relationship. And the way that they were with each other that evening, you would have thought that they were together forever. They were laughing and bagging on each other, making jokes, which was very strange. But you could also tell that they really respected each other and they really admired each other. And it was really refreshing to see. They matched each other in so many different ways, their humor and their patience and their kindness. So it was really evident from early on that they were truly meant to be together. Cameron, I'm so happy that Michaela's car broke down as many times as it did, because it brought the two of you together. Yeah. So.
Your AC, the best thing never happened.
I know you will continue to give her all the happiness and love and support that she deserves. In the 14 years that I've known Michaela, I can say that I've never seen her as happy as she is the last 4 years. Michaela, I felt really bad for you every time you used to tell me about all your car problems, but I think you're good now.
You got the hookup.
And then then just lastly, to both of you, I just wanted to say I love you both, and I'm so happy for you guys. Congratulations on this beautiful evening, and I'm just so excited to see you guys begin to build the life of happiness and love that you guys deserve. So thank you.
Drop it.
I don't even know the last time I've used a microphone. Usually I just yell at people with my normal voice, but this is a treat. I feel like if you're here, you know who we all are, but I am not the oldest sister, the extra most bestest sister. And pretty much I feel like everybody here knows our family in some capacity. And if you know us, you know that we have a few quirks as a family unit. So now that Cameron is legally stuck with us forever.
You got me.
I apologize. It's too late to run.
Yeah.
I wanted to give you a few helpful hints and reminders for surviving this group. Okay. Number one, every event that is tied to our family has 3 start times. The time that my mom and my aunts are given, the time that the rest of us are given, and then the time that it actually starts, which is the time that Cheech is given because she is the only one that is ever on time. And mind you, she's the one with the most and the smallest children, and yet she is the only one ever on time. Number two, nicknames are our thing.
Oh, yeah.
Think about that when you name your children. It can be brutal. And at times, your children may not know their legal name, but they will always know their given nickname. And if anybody here doesn't know the familial nicknames, just ask. If you don't know, this is Doodle. If you haven't heard the name Doodle, come find me and I will share the other 35 names you've had throughout your life. Small story, my oldest actually told her preschool teacher that her monkey was picking her up. This is her. And her poor teacher was like, her monkey is coming? Yes. Number three, being in this family and going anywhere means that you are now tied to Kevin Bacon, which is my father. Everywhere, where is he? Where is Dad? Everywhere you go, regardless of the state, regardless of the type of event, somebody knows this man. For all of us, everywhere. So also, yep, be mindful of the rum, because somebody will report back. Lastly, the women in this family are a bit much sometimes. We might be a tad bit crazy, and we tend to not ask for help very well.
What?
Anybody who was a part of all of this knows that that is not our strength. But when we love hard.
Oh yeah.
For life.
Yeah.
And nothing has brought my very dark, blackened soul more joy than watching the two of you. And laughing at you both occasionally. Yeah. But mostly just watching the two of you love each other. And with that said, my hope for both of you is that as the years go on, you remember today. Not just the beauty of the day, or even just the way that you feel, but when, and anybody who's been married longer than 45 seconds can attest to this, the day that you inevitably want to gouge each other's eyes out with spoons, remember that everybody here is your support system. We are your ear. We are the people who will pray for you. We will whisk you away and get you blackout drunk and bring you safely home if needed. But mostly, we love you, and we will always love you. And if you leave, we'll find you. So don't forget. But I love you both.
Yeah, I love you. Oh, that's beautiful. Thank you.
The father of Brian, Michaela's dad, Jerry.
We're friends now?
You know everybody.
Okay, I kind of, let's see, not to cry this time, but I can't guarantee that. when you're the father of four daughters, you all have unique personalities. Cerise and I have that don't F with me attitude and get out of my way because I'm taking control. Chelsea and I don't spend any money attitude. How cheap can I get this done? And that's still too expensive. This wedding is one of them. Let's see, Tiana and I, well, she made the horrible mistake of going into law enforcement because we think we can save the world. Yeah, kid, yeah, it ain't gonna happen, so we're just gonna chase our tails and pretend. That being said, we have all chosen very wisely. Cerise, not so much, but that's okay. Doug, I love you. all kidding aside, you all married into this family, like Cerise said. Oh, we're sorry. We can be a handful. Mostly because of the women. The guys are not so much, are not so bad. But the women, you know, if they're, you're awesome. They're overpacked with the exception of Chelsea. No suitcase will be under the 50 pound weight limit ever in your lives. Oh, okay, Chelsea may, or Michaela maybe. That being said, Cerise also hit it is, yeah, you can't piss her off. We have lots of guns. I work for a family that may be slightly related to the mafia. They got a big ranch in Oregon and a backhoe.
Okay.
So that being said, yeah, your life is not safe anymore. So that being said, hey, I love you guys. I may have had a hand in putting these two together.
Yeah, she did. That's true.
So, small story, I've known Justin, Cameron's boss, for a crap ton of time. He actually was the original manager at a tire pro shop in Folsom. I met him when they first opened. It's like, hey, this guy's nails, he's honest, he doesn't upsell. What auto supply place doesn't upsell? Justin, if you go to Justin, plug for auto surgeon in Rockland. Hey, if you live in the area, get your stuff served. Get done there. That being said, but so try to make a long story short or long, regardless. Michaela's shop was just down the street from one of the auto surgeon shops, and I said, Dad, I need to get my car fixed. This place is just down the street. I know the owner. Go down there. At some point in the conversation, she says, hey, there's a guy there that's kind of cute. Justin's married, you know, or Justin, he's not available. No, it wasn't Justin. He had hair-ish. So it's like, okay, well, I also had another guy that I went to church with that I had actually got hired by Justin, Dano, and Dano says, hey, dude, I see him at church one day, he says, dude, yeah, Cameron really likes Michaela, I thought she was cute. It's like, this is awkward. I've never been a teenage girl. But here's her number, give it to Cameron. And I think Michaela's coworkers were kind of pushing her, go on a date with her, go on a date. So this is weird because I heard that Cameron at one point says, hey, can I buy you breakfast or a donut or
ice cream.
So, and she denied. And it's like, oh, you do not know flirting at all. She panicked. So that being said, regardless, they kind of got together, and then Justin sends me a text. Dude, Cameron's asking your daughter out. Are you okay with it? I may still have that text saved. I don't know. And it's like, yeah, okay. So that's okay. I'm warning him. Don't cross the line. Be a gentleman. It's like, good call. Because he might get killed by myself. Actually, the one you really need to worry about in this family is Monica, my wife. She's scary. I just clean up the mess. That being said, I forgot where I was going with this. We've got a special bond. The youngest, no one would know this, you know, 30 plus year cop. I'm a musical theater nerd. She is the only one that embraced the musical theater nerd in me, so that's our thing. If we break out into show tunes later, I apologize early, but you know, deal with it. Hence the choreographed dances was not an exaggeration. That being said, I love you guys. Cameron, I'm sorry you're stuck with us, and I love you guys both to pieces.
I love you too, man.
Warm makeup.
Thank you.
What? And now, Mr. DJ.
Thank you, friend. Ladies and gentlemen, please grab those glasses and let's cheers Cameron and Michaela. Cheers. All right, now we're going to have them make their way over to the cake table.
Okay.
Is it straight? Slide her under. Oh, something. Where do I put the knife?
Just look down.
We're gonna turn and switch to each other so that everyone can see.
Do I need to eat the cake?
There we go. Yeah.
There you go.
That's a big bite.
Okay, let's go.
I want more.
You're my inspiration, girl. You take me places, put the words right into these songs. Stealing kisses undercover, babe. See forever when I see your face. And I swear God made you for me. You make it easy. Enough on you. Make it easy.
ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Cameron and Michaela. All right, Michaela, let's get your dad out here for the father-daughter dance.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment in each other's face. So much love you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for you not long ago. I was her number. She told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart from the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I pray that she find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman away to you be the same freckle-faced kid that I knew? The one that I read all those fairy tales to, tucked into bed all those nights. And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of still hard to give her away. I loved her first. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through. Smiles of you, I loved you first.
Ladies and gentlemen, give me everything you got for Michaela and your dad.
Yeah.
See, they need it to practice. Got that choreograph going down.
No practice.
No practice, that's great. Alright guys, we're going to go ahead and open up our dance floor. There's a certain romance in the air, and we're going to take advantage of that right now. So bring someone very special to the floor at this time.
cha cha now, y'all. Now it's time to get funky. To the right now. To the right. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha cha, real smooth. Right foot now. Left foot now, y'all. Cha cha, real smooth. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Reverse. Reverse. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Reverse, reverse. Reverse, reverse. Cha cha now, y'all. Cha cha again. Cha cha now, y'all. Cha cha again. Turn it out.
Yeah. I'm sorry. looking at.